The settling of the Marianas was part of the larger human expansion of Austronesian speakers into island Southeast Asia. Between 2500 and 2000 BCE, Austronesian speaking peoples from Taiwan expanded into the Philippines, and by 1500 BCE, the migration stream split into the Indo-Malaysian archipelago and into the north coast of New Guinea and the Bismarck archipelago. Around 1500 BCE, the Austronesian ancestors of the Tsamoru people split off somewhere from island Southeast Asia to settle the Marianas. The question is, from where? Guahusipulin, and we will explore the ancestral origins of the Tsamoru people. The archaeological, genetic, and linguistic evidence clearly points to the Philippines and or Indonesia as the likely origin point. Let's review the evidence. The strongest archaeological evidence for the Marianas-Philippines connection is pottery design. When the Austronesians expanded from Taiwan into island Southeast Asia, they brought their tradition of pottery making. And over the generations throughout island Southeast Asia, the ancestral traditional pottery would evolve into unique forms of localized pottery. One famous example is the Lapita pottery that first appeared in the islands of the Bismarck Archipelago around 1400 to 1250 BCE. So when people migrated to the Marianas, they brought with them their unique localized pottery and pottery making knowledge. And through comparing the earliest pottery designs in the Marianas with the pottery designs throughout island Southeast Asia, it is possible to locate where the pottery originated from and thus where the people originated from. In the earliest Marianas sites, archaeologists have found that one of the earliest types of Marianas pottery is decorative red slip pottery. Therefore, the first Mariana Islanders must have come from a place where people made this specific type of decorative red slip pottery prior or around 1500 BCE. So far, the only known place with an identical batch of this pottery is found in the northern central Philippines. Similar decorative red slip pottery is also found in a few parts of Indonesia and in the Lapita cultural complex in parts of New Guinea and the Bismarck Archipelago. However, they are not an identical match. Therefore, from the available pottery evidence, the earliest Mariana Islanders likely originated from the northern central Philippines. A significant piece of archaeological evidence supporting a general Marianas-Philippines-Indonesia connection is rice cultivation. The Marianas is the only place in remote Oceania with evidence of rice cultivation predating European contact. And so the tradition of rice cultivation must have come from the Philippines or Indonesia, which extensively practiced rice cultivation. As of now, rice cultivation has not been confirmed in the pre-Latte period, suggesting that later cross-cultural contact brought rice cultivation to the Marianas. Genetic evidence supports the Marianas-Philippines-Indonesia connection. A study by Miguel Villar and colleagues shows modern Tsamoru mitochondria DNA lineages, known as haplogroup E, are closely related to the mtDNA lineages found in the Philippines and especially so in Sulawesi and the Moluccas, eastern Indonesia. This haplogroup E, which is found in island Southeast Asia, is rare in remote Oceania, indicating that the earliest ancestors of the Tsamorus came directly from the Austronesian populations from the Philippines and or Indonesia. Villar et al. Concludes that eastern Indonesia is the likely origin point. Another significant mtDNA finding among Tsamorus is the unique haplogroup B4 with a C mutation, which Villar et al. Speculates was introduced by a secondary migration from island Southeast Asia into the Marianas around 1000 CE, which coincides with the earliest evidence of the Latte and rice cultivation. Now, one of the limitations of modern genetic studies, such as the Villar et al. Study, is that the genetics of the modern population may not necessarily reflect the genetics of the past population, especially considering that 90% of the Tsamoru population died in the late 17th century from a combination of European-introduced diseases and colonization, likely reducing the genetic diversity of Tsamorus. Analyzing DNA from ancient Tsamoru skeletal remains resolves this issue. An ancient DNA study of two human skeletal remains dated to around 100 BC found in Retinian First Cave, Guam, authored by Irina Puback and colleagues, indicates that the ancestry of these skeletal remains are linked to island Southeast Asia, especially the Philippines. Furthermore, the ancient DNA shows no Papuan DNA, which suggests that these early Timorus did not originate from New Guinea and the Bismarck Archipelago. However, these results should be interpreted with caution because these skeletal remains are dated to be about 1400 years after the Marianas were first settled, and there's only two skeletons sampled, which can't be generalized to the entire early Marianas population. The preliminary results of a forthcoming ancient DNA study of pre-Lati and Lati skeletons from Natum Beach Site, Guam, presented by archaeologists Rosalind Hunter Anderson and Joanne Eakin, shows that these skeletal remains have deep East Asian ancestry and that the ancient DNA is related to DNA found in eastern Indonesia, likely Sulawesi. Now, these are significant results which appear to contradict the ancient DNA study done by Puback et al. And the idea that the earliest Mariana Islanders came from the Philippines. However, we have to wait to see until the full study is published before making any definite conclusions. Furthermore, these pre-Lati skeletons are dated to around 500 BCE, a full 1,000 years after the Marianas was first settled. And thus, the genetics of these pre-Lati remains don't necessarily reflect the genetics of the earliest Mariana Islanders. Another significant finding of this study is that there is genetic continuity between the pre-Lati and Lati skeletons, indicating that there was no great population replacement of the pre-Lati Timorus by a secondary group. Historical linguistic studies by linguist Robert Bluss indicate that the earliest Mariana settlers likely came from the northern central Philippines because the Timorian language split off directly from Proto-Malayo-Polynesian or Proto-Western Malayo-Polynesian. Over time, the language of the Austronesian speakers in the Philippines developed differently than from those in Taiwan. This new language would be known as Proto-Malayo-Polynesian, and it would be the ancestral language of all Austronesian languages spoken outside of Taiwan. As the Austronesian expansion continued, the same language branching process of the original Proto-Austronesian language that led to the development of Proto-Malayo-Polynesian would occur, but now it would be Proto-Malayo-Polynesian branching off into different languages, with Timoru being a direct descendant. This makes the Timoru language unique in remote Oceania because the vast majority of the Pacific languages are descended from Proto-Oceanic. Proto-Oceanic is a descendant of Proto-Malayo-Polynesian, and Proto-Oceanic is believed to be the ancestral language of the Lapita, who are the ancestors of most Pacific Islanders. Thus, the vast majority of modern languages in the Pacific, such as Samoan, Chukchis, and Fijian, are descendants of the ancestral Proto-Oceanic language. However, Timoru is not a descendant from Proto-Oceanic, but rather of the older Proto-Malayo-Polynesian, which is further evidence that the earliest Mariana Islanders did not originate from the Lapita. Thus, from a historical linguistic view, the Timoru language split off from Proto-Malayo-Polynesian in the Philippines prior to the development of the Philippine languages and the branching of Proto-Oceanic into remote Oceania. Therefore, the earliest Mariana Islanders likely originated from the northern central Philippines. One last thing to consider is computer simulations of ancient sailing voyages. Two computer simulated studies indicate that it is pretty much impossible to successfully sail to the Marianas from the Philippines. The simulations found that successful sailing voyages to the Marianas were possible from Halmahera, New Guinea, and the Bismarck Archipelago. While Halmahera remains a distant possibility of Mariana's origin, these computer simulations go against a large body of evidence indicating that New Guinea and the Bismarck Archipelago are unlikely to be the origin point. Furthermore, simulations cannot adequately account for the skillful navigational ability of the Austronesians to sail from the Philippines to the Marianas. But it's up to you whether you want to put any weight on computer simulations of ancient voyages. From this review of the archaeological, genetic, and linguistic evidence, it's clear that the earliest Mariana Islanders came from either the Philippines and/or Indonesia. However, what's unclear is which specific place. You may have noticed that the authors are not all in agreement on the exact origin point. They are all familiar with each other's research and extensively cite each other, yet they arrive at different conclusions. Carson et al., Bluss, and Puga et al. Conclude primarily based on archaeological, historical, linguistics, and genetic evidence that the earliest Mariana Islanders likely originated from the northern central Philippines, while Villar et al., Hunter Anderson, and Eakin conclude primarily based on genetic evidence that the earliest Mariana Islanders likely originated from eastern Indonesia. One possible explanation to reconcile these differing conclusions and apparent contradiction in genetic evidence is that the ancestral origins of the Tomoro people came from a diverse group of peoples from the Philippines and Indonesia. The material culture of pottery and historical linguistics make it abundantly clear that Austronesians from the northern central Philippines migrated to the Marianas by 1500 BCE. But it wasn't as if the earliest Mariana Islanders comprised only of one group of people. Rather, many other peoples from the Philippines and Indonesia may have also migrated and contributed to the early Marianas population and settlements, especially as time goes on. This may explain the apparent genetic differences between the two ancient DNA studies, because by 100 BCE, there were probably different groups of people in the Marianas. Sustained cross-cultural contact and immigration from islands Southeast Asia may have led to the introduction or development of the Lati, rice cultivation, and the unique haplogroup B genetic signature in the Marianas by around 1000 CE. Islanders from the now mostly settled islands in remote Oceania likely influenced the Marianas as well. The combination of European-introduced diseases and colonization that killed 90% of the Tomoru population in the 17th century likely reduced the genetic diversity of the Tomorus through the bottleneck effect. But this is just one possible interpretation of the available evidence. You are free to come up with your own interpretation. And until more research is done, the details are still up for debate. Seduce Masi for watching. Guahusipulan, Esta.